Last but not least, we have the floating tool. The floating tool can be activated in one of two ways. The first way is to use the sidebar and select the icon that looks like a pin. This will cause the floating tool to pop up. Now, if we want it to go away, it's as easy as pressing the center easy button and the floating tool is gone. The second way to launch the floating tool is to use two fingers, press and hold them to the board. This will cause the floating tool to pop up under your fingers and you're ready to annotate. If you need to clear your annotation, all you have to use is the eraser icon here on the floating tool, and now we can clear it away. So what if a teacher wants to take her lesson and send it home with one of her students to review later when they get home? We can do that with the record function on the EasyWrite floating tool. All we have to do is activate the EasyWrite floating tool and press the red record button. From here, we'll receive a prompt asking if we want to use the microphone. I'm going to say okay. Now we're recording, and anything I do or say will be recorded into a file. So I'm going to go ahead and annotate on the board. And then I'll end the recording by pressing the red square. A prompt will pop up, let me know where the file is stored, so I can go into AMS files and play that. File, so we'll go ahead and annotate on the board. And then I'll end the recording. And just like that, we can take that recording and send it to one of our students so they can review later on. In addition to the recording tool, we have the cropping tool. We can activate this from the floating menu by selecting the camera icon. Once we press that, we'll get 8 handles on the screen, which will allow us to determine what section of it we would like to take a screenshot of. Alternatively, we can use our fingers to create a picture frame and select what we want. From here, we can select the save icon, save it to our AMS files locally on the board, or we can press the EasyWrite icon to send it right into EasyWrite for us to use on our lesson. And there, it's an EasyWrite, and we can use it as part of our lesson.